My name is Mette Edvardsen, and I'm presenting here a project called Time Has Fallen Asleep in the Afternoon Sunshine. The base of the project is that a group of people learn books by heart. So to develop this as a practice, the learning by heart, and then this is transmitted in the act then of being read by readers or visitors, audiences that come and choose a book they would like to read, and then we recite our content to them. So usually the project is presented in libraries, public spaces, public libraries, often then in performing arts or visual arts or literature contexts. To start with, I asked six people to join me, so me together with them. So we were seven people, you know, trying what does this mean to learn a book by heart? Is it possible? What is this practice that we are developing? And the people that become books, it's a photographer, a scholar, there has been students, there's different people that have joined the project. And I think the main, the main thing is that, well, the desire, the motivation, you would like to do it, but then maybe like what kind of capacity you need to have is more you need to be able to read so that you can learn it. Everyone should become a book. I think everyone can become a book. There's no code to share. I mean, you can just pick up a book that you would like to learn and then you do it. And sometimes also people write to me that they would like to become a book. And sometimes even they know which book they want to become. When you learn a book by heart, it's not that once you've done it, you have it. You have to keep doing it, otherwise you forget it again. So for me, the main... I'd say the heart of the project is really in this commitment to the doing and doing it again and staying with the practice more than the achievement of it. So the readers or visitors, audiences that comes to the library or to the space here can choose a book they would like to read. And then they will meet the person who will introduce themselves. Usually we say, I am, and then the title of the book and the author. So in my case, I say, I am a cat by Soseki Natsume. In some sense, it's a quite intimate experience, but not intimate in the way that challenges the reader to, you know, transgress any borders. It's not about that, but it's really a time given to spend together and to be listening and sharing this reading. We are reading this book together. I mean, reading is a kind of a solitary experience usually. And that's also why the one-to-one seemed important in the project. It's not, we're really trying to create a reading experience, speaking it by memory. But that's also a way of a reading for me. I mean, I didn't write this book. I've learned it by heart. The format is kind of proposed through the fiction, the novel by Ray Bradbury, Fahrenheit 451, which is a future vision of a society where books are forbidden. They are considered dangerous. So firemen, they set fire to books. And in this story, you follow the protagonist is a fireman, and there's a moment that he steals a book, starts to read, and keeps books, and he has to flee society, and he joins an underground movement of people who learn books by heart in order to preserve them for the future. So these people then that have been learning books by heart bring them back to paper, write them down from memory, and books are again being, you know, set printed and set out in the world. So this is also, after some years, another step in the project that we went through. So it's been a close relationship with this fiction as a kind of figure to accompany the project.